Alright, we're finally down here at the ground level.
Ah! Didn't think we had any new miners on account of the positions being full up.
You don't. I'm your new boss. You have to do what I say now. Oh, I'm not on the job. Just checking things out around here.
Well, that's a little weird. But as long as Trevor's okay with it, I can't say that I mind. Anyway, I'm Layla. When I'm not mining, I'm tinkering with Gnome, our unofficial mascot. I fill that computer brain of his with all sorts of nonsense and announcements. Of course, if you're here to chat, I'm always happy to talk shop. Especially if you're interested in talking about the heart of Mars.
The heart of Mars. Have you been in Sidonia for long?
This is only my second contract, so I think I've been here for, 4 years now. It's great. I love it here. I'm working on getting those red eyes that are all the rage these days, you know.
Oh, orange.
You'll hear a lot of these other chumps complaining about Sidonia. They say it's boring or dangerous or whatever. Look, I come from an ice planet. These people have no idea what they're talking about. Sidonia is practically paradise compared to where I grew up.
Hey, tell them. Well, that one guy had orange eyes. That might be what she's talking about. So, it's like a patriotic thing or something for Mars? Why would you want to turn your eyes red?
Why? I mean, who wouldn't want cool blood red eyes?
Me?
It's kind of a badge of honor thing around here. People know you're hot stuff when you got red eyes. Also, it freaks people who don't know about them. Except for little kids. They always seem to think it's awesome. Either way, it makes for fun social gatherings.
Huh.
Hey, you okay there?
Yeah, I was just thinking about what you were saying for a second. Got any good mining tips?
Very funny. Who sent you to ask? Was it Rivka?
Who's that?
No, she seems to know what she's doing. I bet it was Hank, wasn't it?
Who's that?
He always acts like he's top dog. But we all know he couldn't mine his way out of a wet paper bag.
Yeah, it was Hank. What a loser.
I knew it. Listen, don't let him in on it. He tends to get real mad.
Huh.
I think he's self-conscious about his performance. And that goes for more than mining, if you know what I mean.
Oh. Say no more. So you program Gnome?
Yeah. Gnome's been down here forever. He's also been broken forever. Can't actually walk or do work. And we don't have it in the budget to fix him. No one's had the heart to junk him. But when I started, I gave him new purpose. I programmed him to tell us local news and announcements. I modeled his responses after my own sarcastic sense of humor. It proved to be popular, so I did what any aspiring comedian would do and gave him a bunch of stupid jokes to tell. People love it. Or at least that's what they say.
I want to hear some of those jokes. You mentioned something about the heart of Mars. What is that?
Oh, so you're interested in the heart of Mars, are you?
Well, what it is.
Word is there's a cave out in the Martian waste with a gleaming node of the purest titanium ore you've ever seen.
Oh.
It's worth quite a lot of credits. But some say the heart of Mars is cursed. Hundreds have gone in search of it, never to return. And every one of them met a grisly fate. Maybe, just maybe. Could be the first to succeed, though. You know, if you think you got what it takes. No judgment if you're too scared.
Cursed ore? Are you pulling my leg?
What? No. I mean, maybe the cursed part isn't real, but who am I to say? Look, I told you what I know. You can either choose to believe me or not. All I can say is that if you manage to find it and avoid the curse, you'll be a legend around here.
Okay, why is it called the Heart of Mars?
Because in Roman mythology, Mars was the god of war. His heart is cold, but tough like titanium. One of the miners started calling it that long ago, and the name stuck. Seems fitting enough.
I think I'm scared. I'm not scared. I'll get that heart of Mars, and I'll show you, by golly.
That's the spirit. You sure didn't seem like the type to be scared off by tales of cursed rocks.
Hell no.
I'll give you the coordinates for the cave.
That's right.
Good luck out there, and be careful.
I'll give him hell. Activities.
Okay, bye.
Okay. Find the heart of Mars. How many stutters, man, every time. Hi.
This here, I could use a break.
But that was female.
I can't imagine being stuck down here gathering rocks for a living when there's an entire universe to explore.
Oh. Cover your mouth. What the hell's the matter with you? I don't think much of this Rivka.
Worker robot coming through. If you are looking for spare parts, look elsewhere. I need mine for structural stability.
I don't want your parts. There's a lot of people around here. I gotta talk to all of them.
Hey there. You a new hire? I thought all our positions were full.
Oh, no, I'm just here to talk.
How about that? Well, if you're interested in mining, I could talk your ear off. Anyway, I'm Andres. Nice to meet you. Something else I can help you with?
Have you ever heard of this Heart of Mars thing?
Heart of Mars? Oh, you best not get mixed up in that. I'm not gonna stop you, but don't tell me I didn't try to warn you. Nothing good can come of it.
Really? Mars is pretty harsh. How's the mining pay compared to other places?
Let's just say that I've made enough here to retire early if I wanted to, and do something else with my life. Still not sure that's what I want yet, though. Other operations? I'd probably have to put in another 10, 15 years to get to where I am today. Deimos seems to prioritize its employees, which is a nice change of pace from the industry.
Okay, so you're thinking about retiring?
Just for mining, not work entirely. I think about it every time my contract comes up. See, I'm quite a few systems away from my family. I get to see them whenever I get the chance, but it's hard watching my kid grow up without me. And it's not easy on his mom either. I'm conflicted because the job pays so well. And I want to earn enough so that my kid never has to do what I did to make ends meet.
Yeah. You're like stuck between the two. You've got to make whatever choice is best for you.
Yeah, I know. It's going to take some real soul searching to figure it out. I have a feeling it's going to be one of those cases where whatever I choose, it'll be the right decision, and yet the wrong decision all at once. Time will tell.
Yeah, it'll be like that. Been doing this a while then, I guess?
About 15 years now. It's good work. Good money. Only problem is that it keeps me away from my family. They live well, but I hardly see them.
Yeah, you've been over that.
Who knows? Maybe this is the year I let my contract renewal lapse and I finally retire.
All right, well. Whatever you choose, best of luck to you then.
Later.
A sober Sidonia is a safe Sidonia. While indulging in alcoholic beverages is not discouraged, operating heavy machinery while under the influence is dangerous to yourself and those around you.
Mars is ripe with resources, which means there's always going to be plenty of work.
That's good.
We have the tech to instantly jump across the universe. I think someone invented a way to keep rocks out of boots.
hope this hearing loss isn't permanent.
Hearing loss?
Things can get pretty glum out here. If you ever need a little joy, go talk to that Renee kid.
Renee?
She's always trying to make people happy.
Hey, Renee. Speak with Renee. Stutters. Restarting.
Report any injuries I may cause to my supervisor. Iron deposit detected. Initiating evisceration protocols to remove mass from human body. Ha. Just kidding. My programmer had a sense of humor.
You would happen to say that when you're hiding in darkness. It was very sinister.
Am I glad I got this job instead of mining some dead rock out in the middle of nowhere?
Is this hot? Can I save the game? Can I? Well, I can jump over it. Alright, who else is here? Maybe we'll just run into this Renee person. Did I talk
Error.
To
you? Reading procedure 005799EF. Not found.
Okay, you go find that, I'll be over here.
He can make it work in the deep mines. That's where you make the big bucks.
Mining's fair work, but you can't take it all so seriously, I always tell my mates. We're pulling rocks out of the ground, not building spaceships.
Welcome, welcome. Nice to meet you. Name's Trevor, mining director for the Deimos Mining Project here in scenic underground Sedonia. I could spare a minute or two to chat. So long as you're not looking for mining work, I suppose.
What's with the klaxon and the detonation announcement that I've been hearing over and over again?
Oh, that! Nothing to worry about. We do fracking on Mars with subterranean particle detonations. Those announcements are just to let people know when to expect them. Now, you probably felt the rumble when the detonations actually go off. That's all it is. Not too bad, eh?
Well, you're doing what with particles? Are these like mini nukes or something? Fracking with subterranean particle detonations. What's that?
Basically, it's high-tech mining. We use immensely powerful controlled particle detonations deep underground to loosen up subterranean gases and other difficult-to-gather resources so we can harvest them.
You harvest gases?
Sounds way more dangerous than it is. Probably. Actually, it's still pretty dangerous if you don't know what you're doing.
Well, now I'm even more concerned that particle detonations are happening around me all the time.
Oh, come on, mate. It's perfectly safe. We're miles away, so all we get is a little jiggle now and again.
Red eyes.
Just make sure to hold the railing when going downstairs and you'll be fine.
Take a tumble, huh? So how goes the mining operation here on Mars?
Not so bad for one of the oldest mines in the settled systems. We struggle with the lack of decent equipment, but we work hard and make up for it. As I'm sure you know, we're responsible for supplying resources to Deimos Star Yards, which in turn is responsible for supplying UC naval vessels. That, among other major projects, makes us one of the United Colony's most important mining operations. The prestige and pay that comes with it almost makes up for being stationed at the arse end of the settled systems in the middle of nowhere.
So I guess you're the boss around here?
Yep, that's me. Joined up with Deimos when I was just 17 as a mining gopher. Go for this, go for that, you know how it is. I worked hard, proved myself capable, and got the promotion to mining director about 6 years ago, after the old boss retired. Some of the older guys resent me, but I give everyone a lot of leeway as long as they meet their quotas. So that keeps them happy enough.
They resent you, huh? I heard something about the heart of Mars. What do you know about that?
The who's and what's it? Sorry, mate. I've got no idea what you're on about.
Oh, I had the loop, huh?
Sounds made up if you ask me. But then again, maybe the other miners have been inventing some jargon I'm not familiar with. Best to ask around.
I am. I used to do mining work for Argos. I was hoping you'd have work, but doesn't sound like it.
Argos, huh? Yeah, I've heard of them. That's great, but yeah. Unfortunately, all our mining contracts are filled right now.
Unless... maybe you could help me out with a job. Off the books.
Oh, really? I don't know. Seems a little sketchy.
Nah, well, if I'm being upfront, maybe a little. But I promise, it's harmless.
See, you might have noticed that our equipment ain't exactly holding together like it used to.
Yep, not in the budget.
Problem is, we can't get new equipment unless we start exceeding our quotas. And we can't do that until we get new equipment. A real dilemma, right?
Mm-hmm.
I've got a plan for solving our little problem, though.
You do. I don't understand why I come into play.
I'm getting there. First, I need someone from the outside to bolster our yield so we can prove that we can exceed our quota. I'll fill you in on the rest of the details after you've hauled up some ore. One standard quota should do. I need to know I can trust you with the easy stuff first.
Why not just hire more miners? I know, first you have to see you can meet quota.
Yeah, don't you think I want to? Corporate sets the contracts and they're not giving out anymore, so we work with what we've got. Something to do with insurance, benefits, and other liabilities, so I don't make the rules.
Are you sure you're not just exploiting me for free labor?
Of course not. I'll pay you out of my own pocket.
Okay.
I care about my miners, even if corporate doesn't understand our struggles down here. I'm willing to put in some sacrifices to help. That's just the kind of guy I am. If I had the credits to buy all the equipment myself, I would. But this is the next best thing.
All right. Sounds easy, I hope. I'll do it.
When you've got enough, drop it off in the bin over there for processing. Then come see me.
Activities. All right.
Staff would like to join.
First, we gotta talk to everybody. Oh, here's Gnome. Gather iron, 0 of 10.
Hello, stranger. I am Gnome. What can I do for you?
Huh. You look like you've seen better days. What happened to you?
I was activated 17 years ago. I malfunctioned and have been in disrepair and unable to move for over 9 years. Repairs are too costly, and I am well past my warranty expiration. Now, my primary function is that of an automated personal assistant. It was chosen over deactivation.
Okay. Well, I don't know what you can do for me, though.
I can make general announcements and relay messages from one registered miner to another. And I can report about local news. All news and information has been supplied by employees of Deimos' mining operations. I also have been programmed with a limited selection of jokes. But I have been told to warn you, they are not good.
Tell me a joke.
Why did the snowman need a moist towelette? Because his arms were sticky.
Okay. Do I have any messages? I can't.
Sorry, you must be an employee of Deimos Star Yards to access the messaging function, and you are not.
What's the latest announcement?
Don't forget, this month's target goals have been increased by 5%. Failure to meet your new goal may result in termination of your current contract. Good thing you do not work here.
Yeah, that's not a happy announcement. What's happening in the local news?
No doom with this quake. A helpful reminder that subterranean particle fracking has resumed after its recent hiatus. Residents and workers alike are encouraged to heed the warning announcements and brace themselves for any turbulence when the blasts go off. Thankfully, you can rest easy knowing that detonations no longer occur at all hours of the night. Feel free to toss your alarm clocks, however, because they resume bright and early every morning.
Huh. Doom and quake. Alright. Tell me another joke.
My doctor told me I need to cancel my camping trip and sell my circus tickets. She said I needed to avoid activities that are intense. Intense. Get it?
Anything else in the news?
Gone, but not forgotten. Rumor rumors swirl about the return of the famed Red Devils. Authorities have reportedly been in discussions to re-establish Mars's most elite fighting force. Of course, I've been reporting this news for 15 years straight. But yes, surely, this time it's really going to happen.
Yep, we come a cropper. Any more news?
There is currently no new news to report.
One more joke.
Where does a general keep his armies in his sleeves?
I'm done.
I am registering that you are leaving. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Six circle. Oh, wait, that's what they told us not to go.
Careful near the railings on the upper levels. It's a long way down.
Well, I came from there, so I've already seen it.
Only a qualified supervisor may change my directives.
I'm not trying to change your directives.
The Lux condos aren't anything special, but plenty of people call them home.
Oh, it's an elevator. I'm like, something I'm looking for is in this block. Yes, it's an elevator, and that was a stutter.
Careful around the equipment. Don't want to lose an arm or something.
Yeah, I might have to go looking for it. This is just random storage. Stutters. What was that? I'm picking up her. Even though I wasn't even looking that way. Oh my god. It's getting really bad. I don't know why it does this. So, I was supposed to try to talk to somebody? I offered to do some work for Trevor Petyar, but before he gives me my task, he needs to know he can trust me. I've agreed to help him by mining some additional ore to add to his team's quota. Layla Pulaski told me about something called the Heart of Mars, an extremely valuable chunk of titanium in a cave on Mars. The manager of the Sidonia UC Exchange, Dennis Averin, is missing a shipment. The ship itself did not land where it was supposed to. I volunteered to help investigate. I think I found a potential client. I should talk to them and try to convince them to join up with List. I did. Tree Branch. This is the old stuff. Oh. We can deliver the letter from this poor old lady. So wait a second. These are the completed ones. Speak with Renee. Where's Renee? Renee is up there.
This life ain't easy, but it pays the bills.
That's right. Oh, Renee is in residential. Okay. so we're going there after. Check out my ship's inventory. I have a lot of activities to do. What about his... Where's that? This one. Gather the iron, okay. Alright, my mining cutter out. Where am I mining? Anywhere?
What's the matter with you?
I'm mining. Do you mind? The mine? Where am I supposed to be mining? Is that not the right place? What's up here?
People always ask me what I think about mining.
Ugh.
It rocks.
Not again. You tell me not to fire it. Oh, we've got some kind of control center or something like that over here. Control booth. Unoccupied. Yeah. I'm not completely hidden. Or is it her that I'm revealed to? Shouldn't be. I mean, I guess that's fine, the little green on the side, right? See, now the green is gone. Does that mean you're hidden and there's goodies? With the little green? I don't know. And I don't know where I should be mining. Somewhere around here. Right there. And there's a light. Oh, maybe I do this. I'll mine you. Oh wait, here we go. Stealing your jobs. Watch that thing. Here we go. More. Done. Oh. Oh, I gotta put it in the ore hopper. Nice.
Okay. I can see you're serious about helping me. That ore you mined is really gonna bolster our numbers.
It took like 2 minutes. Yeah, I dropped it off as you requested.
Great. Now, The next part is a little trickier. Our director of mining operations, Peter Brennan, fired his last assistant over a month ago. Peter's the only one who can approve the order for new equipment, and unfortunately, he's useless without an assistant. I think I've got a surefire way for you to get that job. Then you, as his assistant, can get him to sign off on the approval.
Wouldn't it just be easier to ask him to approve it?
You don't think I've tried? Like I said, the guy is literally useless without his assistant. I don't even know if he knows how to actually use a computer. And everything Deimos does is so mired in bureaucracy because of their contracts with the UC. Which means, unfortunately, we need to do all the things by the book if we want them done at all.
Alright, so you want me to actually become this guy's real assistant?
We just need you to take the job until we get the approval signed. Then you can quit, keep it, or do whatever. It's not as bad as it sounds. Worst case scenario, you may have to go fetch some stuff for him and go over his messages. It'll be easy, promise.
Sure, I'll take the job.
Now hold on, it's not that easy. You'll need to apply for it like anyone else.
Okay, sure, I'll apply
for
the job.
Head to the Deimos Star Yard's office up in orbit to fill out the application.
In orbit?
It's where that job is posted. Come back and see me when you've done that, and we'll talk about how to secure the position for you.
You're jumping through a lot of hoops to get those miners the equipment that they need.
I didn't anticipate all this. I didn't know I was going to go in orbit just to apply.
Don't worry. We're going to make sure you get that job.
That's different from what you sounded like a minute ago. Hold on, you need to apply.
See you around.
Yeah. So, we're not doing that yet, because I'm still looking around here, and that's... That's in orbit. Oh, I think I did see that from orbit. I thought it was on the planet. Where did I come from? From here, right? Did I go up here? Or did I actually come from all the way up here? I might have come from up here. I did. Oops. Oops. Yeah, there's the heart and all that stuff. I might have seen everything here. I'm not completely sure. Hopefully I did. We'll go to a residential section next time. And then I can drop this off. Zawadi from the residential district on New Atlantis wants me to deliver a letter to her pen pal in Sidonia, to Hattie. Alright, so we're gonna do that when we explore the residential section next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.